Dr. Sandeep Kaur. I would like to introduce my recent review article authored by myself and Dr. Vanna Sharma, published in the Open Microbiology Journal, which is titled The Effect of Probiotic Intervention in Ameliorating the Altered CNS Functions in Neurological Disorders. First of all, the section focuses on the different alarming statistics pertaining to the increased incidence of mental ailments worldwide. Depression has been likely to be the second leading disability worldwide as per report by WHO. The worst part is that people shy away talking about their mental ailments and they do not open up as they do so for their physical ailments, making the whole treatment protocol very complicated. Recently, there has been an interest in the role of gut microbiota in maintaining brain homeostasis through the gut-brain axis. The gut microbiota, which is also called the second brain, actually releases a range of biochemicals, a range of neurochemicals, which have a direct and indirect effect on maintaining brain homeostasis. So we have focused on that. And the good news is that our gut microbiota is malleable, it is not static, and by the regular intake of certain bacteria, which we call it as probiotics, we can actually strengthen our gut microbiota. The article also focuses on the different forms of probiotics which are available and which should be administered and in what dosage. Then we have focused on the different evidences, the evidence-based studies from animals as well as from humans, in which a range of neurological disorders has been discussed, and it has been found out that different combinations of probiotics, different strains of lactobacillus and bifidobacterium, bacteroides, have been shown to actually significantly improve the symptoms associated with the range of neurological disorders, be it Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, or for that matter, depression, etc. Then the major section has focused on the mechanisms which are associated with how these probiotics, also called psychobiotics, actually impact the altered CNS functions. It can be through restoring the heightened HPA axis activity. It can be through upregulation of neurotrophic factors, which are generally, decreased in people suffering from psychotic disorders. Many combinations of probiotics actually upregulate a very important neurotrophic factor called BDNF. Then we have restoration of the CFOS expression in mice, which has also been seen. That can be another mechanism. Then we have focused on the role of probiotics and different combinations in stimulating the vagus nerve activity, maybe by production of butyric acid, maybe by direct interaction of the vagal efferent activity. Then we have also discussed about many indirect mechanisms. Lastly, the article focuses on what are the important challenges associated before probiotics can actually come to be looked into the clinical scenario. For example, safety profile, dosage regime, targeted drug delivery, what categories of probiotics combinations are more suitable for a particular category of neuropsychiatric and neurological disorder that needs to be worked on. So finally, in conclusion, I would say that our gut microbiome is completely malleable. We can strengthen it. And evidences suggest that probiotics are an important and useful dietary modification and should be a part of the treatment regime as recommended by the physician. Thank you for listening to the podcast.